Questo racconto di Gesù è molto chiaro.
This story about Jesus is very clear.
Può sembrare un racconto per I bambini.
It seems like a story for children. It's very simple.
Gesù vuol indicare con questo.
But Jesus wants
non solo
to
una
point
storia,
out through this, it's not just a story,
sino, ma la possibilità.
He wants to point out the possibility
che tutta l'umanità viva così.
That
anche che noi tutti viviamo
all of humanity
così.
Live this way, even we can live this way.
Due uomini.
Two men.
Uno soddisfatto.
One who is satisfied.
Che sapeva vestirsi bene.
Who knew how to dress well.
Forse cercava I più grandi stilisti del tempo.
He probably sought out the greatest fashion designers of his time. He dressed in purple and fine linen.
Perché ogni giorno si dava a lauti banchetti.
He lived well because every day he gave great feasts. He was happy that way. He had no concerns.
Prendeva qualche precauzione. Forse qualche pillola contro il colesterolo per I banchetti.
He took some precautions. He may have even had to take a pill for cholesterol because of all of his feasts. He was happy, tranquil.
Alla sua porta stava un
povero. At his door was a poor person, Lazarus, he was called.
Lui sapeva che c'era il povero.
And he knew that the poor man was there.
Lui sapeva.
He knew that.
Sembrava naturale.
But it seemed natural, normal.
La passo bene.
I live well.
Questo?
And he?
Ah, così è la vita.
Ah, such is life. He'll make do.
Al massimo, forse, non lo dice il Vangelo.
Maybe at the most the gospel doesn't say this.
Qualche cosa, qualche briciolo.
But I might send some crumbs to him.
E così passò la vita di
and
questi
so
due.
These two live their lives like this. Both.
Sono passati per la legge di noi tutti, morire.
According to the law that touches all of us, they died.
L'Angelo dice che Lazzaro è stato portato.
The gospel says that Lazarus was taken to heaven with Abraham, to the bosom of Abraham.
Stato sepolto.
And for the rich man, it just says he was buried.
Fini.
And that's it.
Due cose che colpiscono.
Two things that hit me.
Il fatto che
the fact that
il ricco sapesse
the rich man knew
che c'era questo povero
that there was this poor man
e che sapesse
and that he
il
also
nome Lazzaro.
Knew his name was Lazarus.
Ma non importava.
But he didn't matter.
Le sembrava naturale.
It seemed normal.
Anche il ricco forse faceva I suoi affari.
And even as the rich man went about his business,
alla fine andavano contro I poveri.
In the end, he was against the poor.
Conosceva.
He knew.
Bien chiaramente. Era
clearly, he was informed
di questa realtà.
About that reality.
La seconda cosa che a me
the second thing
è la parola
that hit me about the word
grande abisso,
the great abyss, the great
ricco.
Gulf that Abraham talks
tra
about.
Noi c'è un grande abisso.
For us there's a
non
great abyss, gulf there, that
non
we can't communicate, over which we can't communicate, that we can't pass from one side to
è
the other.
Abisso.
And that same gulf, that same abyss, which in life
c'era fra il ricco
there was between,
Lazzaro.
That same abyss was present also during life between Lazarus and the rich man. It, that gulf didn't begin on the other side. It began in life. To think that
il drama di quest'uomo.
To think about the drama of this man, the drama of being very much informed, but with a closed heart. The information of this rich man did not penetrate his heart. It didn't move him. He wasn't moved about the drama of another person. He may have said to one of his servants, "Ah, take him something." The drama of information that doesn't penetrate the heart. This also happens to us, all of us. We all know because we've heard it on the television or we've seen it in the newspapers, how many children suffer hunger today in the world? How many children don't have the necessary medicines? How many children cannot go to school? Continents with this drama. We know this. Poor people. And then we continue. This information doesn't penetrate our hearts. And how many of us, how many groups of men and women live in this detachment from between what they know and what they feel? The heart is detached from the mind. They're indifferent. As the rich man was indifferent about the pain of Lazarus. This is the abyss, the gulf of indifference. When I went to Lampedusa the first time, this is the word that came to me, the globalization of indifference. Perhaps we today, here in Rome, we're concerned because the stores are closed and I need to go and buy someone and I can't go out for a walk every day, concerned about my own things. And we forget the children who are hungry. We forget the poor people
who are
at the borders of nations looking for freedom, people who are fleeing from famine and war, and who only find a wall.
Fatto
a wall
di ferro, un muro
made with iron
filo spinato, ma muro che non
or with
passare.
Wire, but a wall that doesn't allow them to pass through.
Sappiamo che
we know.
Questo, ma
we know that this exists, but it doesn't penetrate the heart. It doesn't pass to the heart.
Nell'indifferenza.
We live in indifference.
L'indifferenza è questo dramma.
We live the indifference of this drama of being well informed, but we don't feel the reality of others. This is the abyss of indifference. And then there's another thing that hits me. Here we know the name of the poor man. We know it's Lazarus, and even the rich man knew that, because when he was in the underworld, he asked Abraham to send Lazarus. He recognized him here and asked him to send him. But we don't know the name of the rich man. The gospel doesn't tell us what this man was called, what his name was. He didn't have a name.
Aveva perso il nome.
He had lost
soltanto
his name.
Aveva gli aggettivi
he only
della
had
sua vita.
We only have the adjectives of his life.
Ricco,
rich,
potente,
powerful,
tanti aggettivi.
Many adjectives.
Questo è quello che fa l'egoismo in noi.
This is what egoism does within us. It makes us lose our real identity, our name.
Soltanto ci porta a valutare gli aggettivi.
It only makes us choose adjectives. Worldliness takes us there. We're open to the culture of adjectives, where your value is what you have, but we don't know what your name is. You've lost your name. Indifference brings us to that point, to lose a name. And so we're only rich. We're this, we're that. We're the adjectives. We're reduced to adjectives. We ask the Lord today the grace of not falling into indifference. The grace that all the information of human suffering that we have might penetrate our hearts and might move us to do something for others.